At the age of 18, Twina Julius dropped out of school since his family had inadequate funds to further his studies when he completed ordinary level. But who could have known that this could not halt the dreams in the young man's mind? Today, he is codenamed the Young Innovator with over 5 prototypes to his name, such as a radio powered by solar energy and an energy-saving bulb.
This will be a switch. It is under process. It will be a switch when you install it in your house. It will be a switch. It is able to give you, like per now as it is able to give you light for 2 days or 1 day.
Julia speaks with much pride of his innovations, boasting in their ability to solve the country's economic and social problems.
In those past 5 years, I did some new ideas like 2010 new system of GAN, 2011 new community radio station, where I used that community radio station in competition that is district level and national level plus East Africa, where I was where I acquired the second position and certificates and trophies and so on. But by then I was doing them under school.
Twina Julius visions himself becoming one of the greatest minds remembered globally, following in the fields of the world's greatest minds in science, such as Albert Einstein and the man who made the world's first electric bulb, Thomas Edison. He dreams of going back to school and appeals for more support to further his innovation dreams, looking for funding at a tune of over 200 Ugandan million shillings to further his innovation dreams.
Of course, in every setup it needs money, almost 200 million or 300 million to start to set up, minus these requirements. But that money, like 300 or 200 million, they are needed, like set up the factory, buying things of computers, lab, and so on, electronic gadgets requirements, and testing boards, and so on. Like 200 or 300 million, they can do that for setup.
Africa in general and Uganda in particular is slow striding in advancing technological and innovation capabilities, ranking low in technological innovations, human capacity and other measures of economic competitiveness. Uganda also for a long time has relied on imported products. Therefore, such innovations from young mind could bring the country to a more competitive place on the world market.
Well, I think Uganda has enormous potential in innovation, and what has been lacking is the attention we've been giving to innovation. Luckily, that is changing. It has changed. So we now have initiatives within the Ministry of ICT and National Guidance that are there to support these innovations. The other important ingredient was the standardization of innovations that the young innovators put onto the market. That is also being addressed. We have the National IT Authority with a whole list of standards that we shall follow to ensure that the products that these people put out in the market can be consumed by first we as government and then the public, and where possible, export those innovations.
Uganda has allocated over 15 billion Ugandan shillings into boosting innovations among the youth, as 80% of the country's population is youth, something that the likes of Julius Twine benefit from. Report by Aloysius Satwine for Urban TV.